Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to our channel, It's a Trap. Today, we're gonna make a new playlist of a care guide regarding carnivorous plant. And this time, we'll do it in the language that most of us can understand. Before we proceed, I would like to share a short passage that can be found on Genesis 1 verse 1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. To relate the passage that we just read, today we're gonna study and learn about the basic of caring about carnivorous plant. I remember the time when I got my first Venus fly trap. I tried to feed it with a fly in the first day, and after I made a little experiment with my first carnivorous plant, I just put it on the balcony of our house and left it there. After a few days, I remember that I have a Venus fly trap on the balcony and check it, and lo and behold, it was all black and withered, and it's all dry, and obviously my plant is gone and dead. It gives an impression to me as a beginner in carnivorous plant that taking care of these peculiar plants is very difficult. That's why it took me a year before I got another Venus fly trap. But this time, I made the research and I tried my very best not to murder again my second Venus fly trap. So basically, Venus fly trap and other carnivorous plant needs right kinds of soil for them to grow vigorously and acclimate to the environment that you will put them much easily. So the basic medium for carnivorous plant, specifically for Venus flytrap, is 50% sphagnum moss and 50% perlite. But put it in mind that finding a legitimate seller of sphagnum moss is very difficult, because in the Philippines, they are already used to call other moss as sphagnum moss. Java moss, green moss, star moss are oftenly mislabeled as sphagnum moss. So you need to be very careful on buying your sphagnum moss. So I suggest that you buy to those buy a seller that they already have good reviews, or better, ask the seller to send you a picture of the product they are selling and try posting it to the carnivorous plant community if this is the right medium or sphagnum moss for your plant. The other 50% of the medium is perlite, or also known as horticultural perlite. At this time, it is very easy and widely available online and on the agricultural supplies in your place. To give you initial description, it is porous and very light. This is very helpful to have a well-draining soil, and it promotes good aeration to your carnivorous plant. Next will be light or sunlight exposure. So as you know, here in Hungry Pots Carnivorous Plant Nursery, or also known as Pet Plants Philippines, all of our carnivorous plant is grown and propagated outdoor. So as you already know, carnivorous plants, most of them, especially Venus flytrap specifically, they like full sunlight. Here in the Philippines, our climate is tropical. So it is advantageous to us that we use this as a pre-resources to grow a very healthy Venus flytrap. So how much sunlight should I give for my Venus flytrap? So generally speaking, carnivorous plants have different lighting requirements. For Venus flytrap, which is the most common carnivorous plant that we love to grow here in the Philippines, Venus flytrap needs as much as sunlight that you can give. It means growing them fully outdoor, but make sure when you first get your Venus flytrap, you acclimate your first baby slowly and carefully. Place them in the pot where they can get enough morning sunlight, and during 11 o'clock until 3 p.m. where intense light is scorching, you need to give your plants a little shade. After several days, your plants will be ready for fully outdoor environment. So next will be watering your plants. As a beginner, it is better to stay on water tray method so it will not be prone to leaf burn and drying off. But keep in mind that the tray that you will be using should be plastic and not too deep, so that the plants, even in rainy season like this, your plant will be stay in upright position and will not drown even the water level goes higher. So Venus flytrap likes rain water. You can also use the distilled or reverse osmosis water that you can buy on most of the refilling station here in the Philippines. But don't try to use deep well water or tap water if you don't have TDS meter yet. So the safest guide on using the right water in your Venus flytrap, just make sure it is lower than 40 ppm. So let's just say the reading should be 0 to 40 ppm. That's for the beginner. As you become experienced, you will notice that this plant is very hardy, that they can even tolerate higher level of total dissolved solid. So for now, this is the basic care guide for carnivorous plant, and hopefully I can share to you all of my experiences here in our growing area. You can expect that I will be totally honest with you with all my techniques and wisdom on propagating this unique and very beautiful plant. To add to this care guide, as you can see, we are using plastic pots as their planter. It is very helpful also to mention that you need to use protective cages if you don't have a greenhouse yet, because this plant is very expensive and you don't want to feed it on birds or rats around your area. It's better to be safe than giving your neighboring pets a very expensive meal. So if you don't have greenhouse yet, you can use an old bird cage. You can house 20 to 40 3x3 planter in this setup. So you can expect good protection from birds and rats and other small critters. And the poop tray of your bird cage, you can put it inside and use as your water tray. So hopefully you already learned little things about carnivorous plant. So if you find this channel interesting, please don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any suggestion on the next video, or you want to see new content, please just let me know and you can write it on the comment section. Once again, I thank you for having time watching this video, and God bless to all of you. Bye bye.